Hello and welcome back to another exciting learning experience. I will continue with the other group as I explained in the previous tutorial video where I took you through the font group. So we will just continue from there by using our previous exercise file. And I actually forgot to save it in the last video. So if you don't know how to save a file, this is how you go about it. You can go to the quick access toolbar and click on the save button, or you can come to the file tab, click on save, then you browse to the location where you want this particular file saved. So I'll go to browse, then I'll go and locate my Microsoft Excel tutorial, then I'll just leave it here. So I'll save it as Excel call. We need to look at the expert level. So you can also save it with any name that you like. So let's move on to the font group. So the font group basically talk about, I have to take this one off my list. So the font group basically talk about how the text appears on your screen. And I believe most of you know how to do this from Microsoft Word. So all you need to do is to select a particular block of text. So you can click, use the shift and the down arrow, select. Once it's selected, what do? You go to the font group where you have the font styles. So as you go through it, you get to see a live preview of the font that you want. So as you go through it, if you think this is okay, you just click on it. And it's accepted. If you want to increase it, you can just come to the increase font size using the values here, or you can just go right ahead and use grow font and what shrink font in Microsoft Word. So increase font size, decrease font size. So the font group basically is pretty much straightforward. Then you can do a bold, you can do an italic, you can do an underline. Then whenever you see a drop down, it tells you that there are additional options. So you just have to go ahead, click on it, and you have one underline and what double underline. Now we can also talk about applying what borders. So if we decide to print this particular worksheet, what we will see on the paper will just be the items, but not these what grid lines, unless of course you activate the printing settings to print grid line. If not, you would have to actually apply borders to your cell range. So I can come here for the previous lesson, control shift right, control shift down, and it's selected. Now I can come in here and apply all borders. So once I do that, this is what happens. I can come to this particular cell. Then instead of all borders, I can just select pick outside borders or bottom what double border. So once you do that, that is what you get. So if you want to print and still have the borders around it and you don't want it to appear as a plain sheet with just some text on it, then you have to apply borders. But as we move along, when you get to the page layout tab, I'll teach you how to activate, and when you get to the view tab, how to take off the grid lines, then the Excel system just becomes a plain white sheet. So basically that is it. So you can also explore the other options. So as you practice, I'm just showing where the tools are, then you can come and explore, click on this, see what happens. If you want to erase, click on it and apply it. So if I come to erase border, you see, then I click, you see, okay, good. So you drag on it, then it will erase it. Okay, this is gone. So you just have to explore, click, see what happens. And it's not always the case that you have it in black. So you can actually change the color of the border. Then you come in here, then you see what all borders, then automatically it applies it to that particular axis cell. So if I come in here, then I select, it applies the red, unless of course I want to change it, then I come in here and change it to a different color. So once you do that, it gives you more or less like a pencil, but that's not what we are after. So what I'll do is I'll go back again, select my range. So let me hit on the escape, select my range. Then I'll say what, all borders. Then that yellow will be what, applied. So judging from what we learned in under the clipboard sections, I want to copy this particular format. So I use the format painter, I'll do a double click, I'll come and click one, click. And it takes away all of that for us. Good. Then we can also actually talk about the fill what effect. So you, when you come in here, you can just click on the drop down. And as you go through the list, the system will automatically should give you the name as you hover the mouse. So in the Microsoft exam, they will be specific. Apply a blue gray text to lighter 80%. So you need to be aware of the names. So normally the standard colors are here, the dark red, red, orange, yellow, gold, and all of that are down here. And whenever they talk of accents, they are up here. So white background one, black text one, light gray background two. So as you go down the list, it is still light gray background two, but in a different variation, that are 10%. So when you're doing the exam, you should be aware of these tricks. That is it. So as you go through, it's still blue gray. So yours is to identify what you are looking for. Then you can go down the list, green accent six. So if I go, if I come down, green accent six, lighter 80, lighter probably 60, then I come to what, 40, then I come to a darker 25, then darker what, 50. So this is how you apply some simple fill effect to the various cells within your document. So I can just go for this. Then you can also change the font color. So it's not always the case that it is black by default. It's automatic black by default. So if I hover my mouse over the color, you see a preview of it. So as you hover the mouse, you get to see a preview of the color that is being applied. So once you just leave the mouse on a particular color, the system will tell you its name. So basically, that is what the font group is used for. So as you work on your Excel worksheets and you want to make it appealing to whoever you are reporting to, you try to apply some of these little techniques just to make it more, you know, appealing to the eyes. Okay, then we can also come to the dialog box launcher. So I explained that whenever you're looking for a particular tool and you don't find it here, then it means that you can click on the dialog box launcher for that particular group to get access to these additional word functions that are not found within the face of this group. So I just go ahead to click on the dialog box launcher, then it gives me the font tab. So whatever we saw here, they're all here. So you can use the dialog box launcher to change the font style, bold, italic. Then we have the size, which was here. Then we have underline. So even with the underline, we have what, other types of underline. But when you click from this particular session, you only we only saw single and double, but we have single accounting, double accounting. So if you want to use that, you need to execute the dialog box launcher. You can also change the color, and if you want normal font, you click, then it comes back to what, the Calibri, which is the default, and text color being what, automatic black. We never saw strike through, superscript was not there, subscript was not there. So I'll need you to go over this, click, try your hands on it, and see the effect. Then as you practice, then you get to at least solidify your understanding of the Microsoft Excel application. Mind you, we are basically focusing on knowing where to find the tool, because if you're a specialist, you need to be able to know where to find what for a particular job. And once we get the required job skills, I will be in a better position of preparing you to take the official Microsoft exam for a certificate from them. Then we can just show to the whole world that yes, indeed, you are a proficient user, and you don't just say it, but you've got a certificate from Microsoft to prove that. So you just have to put yourself on the global market. So thank you very much. And if you haven't saved it, you have to save it. So you can go and click on the quick access tool, which is the save button, or I just use the keyboard shortcut Control plus what S, and it will be saved. So I'll see you next time in our I'll see you again for our next lesson, where I discuss the alignment group. But before you even come and watch this particular lesson on alignment group, I'll need you to explore that particular group. Then it makes it easier for me to teach you. Then if you have issues, please do all to get in touch with me. You can do it by Zoom or by any desk or by Google Meet, or you can call me, then we can talk about it and help you get a skill set. We take our time to go through it step by step, make sure you get it. Okay, thank you very much, and God bless you for staying with me.